Hey people, Positive Paul. It is Wednesday, June 1st, 2023. And greetings to all the folks out there around the globe. Stephanie in Australia, Patrick up in Canada, and Mirage out there in Nebraska. But this is going to be for my buddy Jude. And thank you for the help you've been giving me as of lately. Much appreciate it. But he's drawn up some questions that I'm just going to jump right into it. A lot of this stuff I've talked about over the years, going back all the way to 2016. But we're going to just directly try to answer these questions without me getting all worked up, hopefully, right? And here we go. Okay, when did you first notice your first UAP UFO? How old were you? Where were you? And he put some locations. Okay, it was on July 14th, 2016, which would be Bastille Day. And what I saw is what I commonly call, as some of you know, the blue underbelly, American Nazi, Edomite, Satanist perp plane. But it came in from the west, where I'm at here in Rosarito Beach, Mexico, up at the place up in the hills. It came in from the west, and the plane was directly above my location. It had all kinds of crazy equipment on it. But as soon as I busted out my phone, the thing disappeared right in front of me. And it would be 2 weeks after that is when they unleashed the harassment campaign on me down here in Rosarito Beach. You know, doing break-ins, all the crazy stuff, people shouting at you on the street, mobbing you in grocery stores or wherever you go. But that was the first time I noticed. How old was I? Okay, well, I'm 57, so it would have been, 50? And it was in Rosarito Beach, Mexico, where I'm at, where my son's mom is from. So prior to that, I don't really think I was clued into anything that I saw, whether it was back in New York or any of the other various locations I found myself at throughout my life. In the military, though, you know, you see things, but they always have a way of explaining it away. So as far as like a full-blown UFO, it would be around that time too. But I attribute the UFO phenomenon to the spiritual realm, which is what I've been talking about since I've been involved in all this conspiracy nonsense. And when and why did you join the Marines? I was essentially forced into it by my sellout father. I went in on November 10th, 1985. College was never going to be an option for me because it would have been too difficult for them to try to control me if I had gone off to college. So in military, we all know if you've been in the military, you're on a short leash. You have to be in formations early in the morning. You go on deployments. And if you go AWOL, that's a big no-no. All right, no one likes a coward or a snitch either. So, how was your overall experience? Very good. I got an honorable discharge, did have some issues, but overall, it was very good. The crazy thing was being out in Camp Pendleton, California, and being able to travel up and down California during the late 80s was definitely, to say the least, interesting. So, did you notice anything odd like you do now during your enlistment? The only thing back then is the type of people I was running into. Now, I did learn one of my handlers, this guy John Rossbon, his uncle had a place up in Huntington Beach off of PCH and Newland by the smokestacks right there. And come to find out, he was a CIA agent. So, look, we know the spider web is there's a lot involved within this satanic sphere of influence, but the people that were coming into my life, some of them, they appear and then the next thing you know, they're gone, only to lead you away from possibly what you might have been, fate or destiny or whatever you want to call it. But this would be a common tactic that they use for people in my situation, meaning MK Ultra, satanic ritual abuse, damage control. So no real UFO sightings anywhere. I was in Korea, Philippines, Japan, Panama, Honduras. And yeah, nothing odd. So, have any of your fellow Marines shared any post honorable discharge from service that may shed any light on your attacks? Or do you believe this is all pre-military service going back to your childhood and then as a teen in Montauk Project? Here's the thing. I had kept in touch with some of these guys for a little while, but by the time after 9/11, more specifically after 2010, I was really only in touch with a few of them. And what ended up happening is when I started running my mouth and testifying, witnessing against these Satanists, they all of a sudden popped out of the woodwork on Facebook because initially I didn't understand how social media worked, how corrupt YouTube is, but I was what you all people are not allowed to listen to me complain about these Satanists and where I fit into this. So the thing of it is, they didn't want to hear it. Only a couple of them, one of them came down. He had helped me out initially financially also, but then he got strapped. But other than that, they had a big reunion the same year, which was 2017, and they knew. They would see that they knew that I was in trouble and I needed help, but none of them, they wouldn't even offer to pay for my trip to come out there and hang out with them in Vegas when they did the reunion. So the thing of it is, these people, a lot of them, they're living in this false reality. They think somehow that they've dodged these Satanists or they're smart enough to keep themselves, from being under the eye of Big Brother. No, that's not the case. As a matter of fact, it's 2nd Battalion, 5th Marines, Comm Platoon. 8589. I could go down the list of characters. Some of them are on Facebook yapping about how, oh, God this, God that. But they've seen the UFO footage and all and everything that comes with it, and they ignored it. So did these people back in where I went to high school at in Vernon, New Jersey. So let's slow down. And I do believe that it's a fact. All this stuff is from birth because I was born into this. I've said this a million times. You cannot be, your family's from Bavaria. They all are part of the military industrial satanic complex going back through World War II. And to make matters worse, my godfather was Lyndon Johnson's vice president, Hubert Humphrey. So with all that and what we know about MKUltra and these implants, it's a done deal. This is why they can only fuck with me. If I was to go to court and testify, it wouldn't work for them. They've got to deal with these implants first. All their Mickey Mouse shenanigans and setups and entrapment schemes, it's all done deal. Anything they have would be completely fabricated, made up lies. Lazy lying lizards. Now, did you have any surgeries at Great Lakes Naval Hospital when it was operational? Nowhere near that place. What do your son's mother and her family think about you? They've had enough of me. All right. The average Mexican, almost all Mexicans across the board, if you talk about satanic ritual abuse or anything, these UFOs, they're going to scratch their heads. It has nothing to do with them, so they think. And the unfortunate thing is my parents have brainwashed my son's mother. And the way that they've drilled down with this neighborhood community watch snitch network, it took them years to get these people turned on me because they knew me before the slander campaign. And then the slander campaign started in 2016 here. And so what it is, it's just the monkey see, monkey do, you know? They all want to get in on their little snitch money. But remember, none of them never done anything about the cartel. Been hiding in their houses. They know if you snitch on the cartel, it's lights out. So yeah, no bueno there. But, you know, I love my son. And I, you know, God tried to do what I can to just, hey, I'm here for questioning. But see, I'm dealing with a bunch of cowards, and then the rest, they can give a shit, all right? Look, there's suffering all around the world. So it's come to a point that they don't realize how Jacob has been destroyed, but there's a remnant. And right now, the remnant is being abused for a little while longer until the plug is pulled. Lights out, no more internet. That will be the day. That'll be the day. Okay, do you believe you are a UFO abductee? Nope. Day one. All right, I got tossed into this MKUltra. A lot of it has to do with satanic ritual abuse. A lot of it has to do with the control of Jacob, the destruction of Jacob by these Edomite Satanists that are over in Europe and wherever else they're festering. Now, is there something going on with these UFOs, these aliens? All right, has anybody, what we see is, see what social media allows is these people to purport their mealy mouth stories of sitting down with the Orion Council of Light, the Palladians, sweeping up their draconian grid. I've taken this stance now since 2016, and I can appreciate someone that says, hey, I've been abducted by aliens, but they got no proof. I got proof. It seems that this whatever it is occurring around me, Paul Wilson Linder Jr. And when it comes to these alien abductees, none of them got their stories straight, all right? They have to use third parties to prop them up. And you would think that by now someone would be able to take a video with their iPhone or whatever device they have. So I do not believe I'm a UFO abductee. These asshole Satanists put these implants in me. They're in my teeth, my feet, back of my neck, and wherever else. And when I went to the VA in 2012, they went into damage control to try to cover this up. Now, can you feel any of them? Have you tried to remove them? Yeah, the one in my tooth, I did get a tooth out, but it's still deep down in there, and I got the x-ray of this. As a matter of fact, I'll put the x-ray of it as the thumbnail for this video. Okay. Would you be open to surgical removal if someone other than the VA offered to remove free of charge? No, I'm not going to let that happen. This look, I know how things are working out for me. Time is short, so I'm just going to ride this out. It sucks. Sometimes it's like, you know, it's painful dealing with this, knowing that there's no relief. There's nowhere I can go. There is no medical system. Do you think they are slowly killing you? Yes. Does all this interfere with your logic and reasoning skills? Sometimes I get a little irate, as you people have learned. I let it rip. But hey, I've got nothing to lose now. They took everything away from me. There is no more. There's nothing they could take anymore. They can't have my soul. I know where I'm going. The people that are involved with me on the wrong side of this, it's a curse. I have a mark. People have been dropping like flies down here in Mexico. You know? It's a hell of a thing, but hey, what can I tell you? All right. UFO experts claim that people who constantly see UFOs likely have multiple implants or track, trace, reabducted many times. Are you aware of this? Yes. My interest in this was back in the mid to late 90s, and my introduction, like everybody else, would have been Coast to Coast, Art Bell. I knew a little bit about Bill Cooper, but we all know 9/11 was our wake-up call for a lot of us to start thinking about, you know, what in the heck just happened here? And should we be concerned that, you know, things are not what they seem? So, do you believe you are a UFO abductee? No. How many suspected or known implants do you have left? Who knows? Let's just put it at a dozen. Because there's at least two active in my teeth, but up here, my teeth are falling out. And that's why they're nervous. And that's why they follow me around in case I slip into a dentist. But the dentist can be bought off. They've been bought off down here. But yeah, there's, you know, I would love to get an MRI, but see, they will corrupt the information, the diagnosis, the assessment with their false progress notes. Okay, are you aware of this? Yes. Evidence. Okay, this is evidence I propose. You have the most visual evidence of UFO UAP activity by any known human in history. Yet, in over 8 years, not one interview or visit. Skinwalker Ranch has nothing on you. I should not be in the financial predicament that I'm in, but I am. I'm blacklisted in the United States. Look, they don't need some guy like me that's going to complain about working conditions or whatever it is I might complain about. This is one of the aspects of flooding in these new migrant worker, transitory migrant worker replacement to keep this Ponzi scheme going. I'm eligible for Social Security in 4 years. I'll be 62, so I'll be eligible for Social Security. All right, so now, my number one concern is, yeah, the implants, being woken up every night. Because the worst they can do and to anybody in my situation is not let you sleep, all right? These Satanists won't come face me down here in Rosarito. So what they do is they buy off the people in the community. And there's already animosity towards Americans because Mexicans and everybody else thinks that Americans are spoiled. All right? They've had it easy. They don't know what suffering is like. On top of a lot of a whole host of issues. So anyway, let's quit while I'm ahead. I did answer all these questions, but Jude, thank you. From the bottom of my heart, everybody that's tried to support me watching my videos, YouTube has unsubscribed almost 100 people in the last, say, 3 months, because when I had my short, I had a massive subscription base go up to about 372, what I saw. They knocked it back down, and now I'm seeing it go back and forth from 368 to 372, and it always gets knocked back. Well, what's the point to that? If my testimony, my witness is of no value to anybody, right? I'm just a nobody, can't prove nothing. You would think they'd let the whole world know, right? But what are they afraid of? And they're propping up these phony social media frauds. Let's keep in mind, these lazy, lying lizards can only mimic, they can only repeat what the real experience of being, whether you claim to be an alien abductee, a satanic ritual abuse survivor, or just a targeted individual. Hey, I report, you decide. Peace, folks.